No! Get away! Hello everybody, Bun Chef is back once more. Today we cook bechamel potatoes. It's made from the main ingredients are potatoes, as the name says, and bechamel sauce. It's an old French sauce made from flour and butter. That's all. Oh, and milk, of course, milk. We start with the potatoes. I don't peel them. I leave the peels where it is, because under that peel are the most nutrients. There are vitamins, all everything that's good for you. And by the way, if you peel them, you have a lot more work. So what's the sense? Just leave them as they are. We start with cooking them, but only until they are half ready. Of course, we need hot water for this. While the water is heating up, we take care of this little fella. It's raw bacon, belly bacon from a pig, a lucky pig, because it ended up in my kitchen. We just don't cut it right away. We need a meat mincer. If you don't have a thing like this, a wooden hammer or a steel hammer to mince the meat, make it softer, you can also take a pan. Beat the shit out of that bacon. And now we're gonna cut it. The first thing you want to cut off is the skin. This is actually the skin of the pig, still there. And it's like just like leather. It's like eating cowboy boots. This has to be cut off. Why did we flatten this? First, because it gets flatter. And second, it gets much more softer, more tender. We peel this with the second. Okay. And we cut it in about two fingers wide strips. Okay, the bacon is cut, the water is hot, everything goes in line. And we let it cook, as I said, until they are half ready. Should take about 15 minutes. So while we wait, we do nothing. And we're back. The potatoes are ready meanwhile. We have to throw away the water. I should have readied a bowl. Let them cool down. Oven plate that's still hot, stays hot. We put the pot back on it and we take a big chunk of butter. Yeah, this pleases the Americans. We melt the butter. This recipe is old family tradition. Maybe some cooks or some French cooks or whatever will scream in agony while looking at this video, looking at me cooking this my family way. But I don't care. This is a bum family recipe from my bum dad and my bum mom, and they made it this way, and I just do it the same way. Okay, the butter is melted down. We add flour now. Not just throw it in there. Be gentle. One at a time. And mix. As you can see, it's mixing up. And when you have a solid chunk of maize flour and butter, could use a bit more. You see, it's getting solid, but we need a bit more. Okay, now we change the spoon to this thing, whatever its English name is, and we take milk from the refrigerator. Needs to be at least cold. This was about 300 milliliters, and now it's mixing time. There shouldn't be any solid parts left in the end. It all has to be one silky smooth fluid. And then we add pepper. I prefer black pepper, you could also use white pepper, whatever. Add a lot of pepper. You will notice that it's getting harder to mix. Not because of the pepper, but because everything becomes one. Everything is mixing up, which it is supposed to do. And when it's getting thicker and harder to mix, just add some more liquid, some more milk. And now we add some muscat. A lot, but not too much. If you eat a whole muscat, you die. It's that toxic. So be a bit careful with this. Realistically, you won't die. You would puke it out, detox yourself before you die. The body won't let it happen. But you shouldn't. Don't eat a whole muscat. And we are about on half a liter now. And this is the part where you can take the heat to zero. The sauce has to be a consistency like ketchup. Not honey, but ketchup. Okay, as you can see, getting along rather well. Okay, next step, we need the bowl because we fill up the sauce in it. And we do this because we need the pot again. So we have to clean this pot now and dry it out. Needs to be dry. Then we take the bacon and place it on the walls. You have to squeeze it flat on the walls. It will stay there. Just by its own fat. And there you go. As you can see, the whole pot has a nice coat of bacon. Bacon. So we put them away and start slicing up the potatoes. Okay, now we have a mountain of potatoes, which sounds like the next Stephen King movie. And we're gonna finish everything up. First step, we make a puddle of bechamel sauce inside the pot. And put the potato slices one by one inside. And another paddle. And more potatoes. And this is getting continued until you run out of potatoes. Now I have surpassed the bacon, and maybe some will scream, "No, you need more bacon!" Yes, I could add bacon up to this point, or even make another mountain of bacon, which would be the next part of mountain of potatoes. But I don't want to end in a hospital with a heart attack, so the bacon only goes up to here and the potatoes continue. I won't stop you. If you want to add more bacon, you can just slaughter a pig and stuff its mouth with potatoes if you desire. I don't care. I'm just showing the legacy of the Bomb family. Okay, now we're ready. Have some leftovers, but you can eat them another day. The top part is potatoes. This is important because the brown degree of the top is indicating if it's ready or not. We now, we have some bacon left. Okay, whatever, put it up there. We put it in an oven and at 200 degrees Celsius, needs to be really hot, and if it's getting brown, really dark brown, almost black, then it's ready. And around 40 minutes have passed. I will take a look in the oven and I'm pretty sure it is ready. This looks perfect. Exactly, this is what you want to have. I'm taking a portion out. It's really creamy, just as it needs to be. Take some bacon. Don't want to ignore the bacon. And there you go. Maybe a bit too hot to taste it now, right now, but I will do it anyway. As you may have noticed, I didn't add salt because the bacon is pretty salty by itself, and that's enough. Perfect. Just as Bum Dad and Bum Mom used to do it. Cooking, I mean. And remember, if you don't like it, there's something wrong with you.